Hi students, today we are going to study the last concept from the quadratic equation, that is applications of quadratic equations. We already complete all the concepts from this lesson and we have to apply these concepts in these world problems. So first of all we will study how to form the quadratic equation when we have given the condition. If you have given the condition in the words, then how to convert this condition into the quadratic equation, that we have to study first, and then we will study the practice set 2.6, which is depend upon the applications of the quadratic equation, that is the word problems. So here we have the question: form equations for the followings. You have given some conditions and we have to follow form the equations for these conditions. Only we have to form the quadratic equations, no need to simplify them, just we have to form the quadratic equation. Here we have first example: the sum of natural number x and its square is 30. The sum of a natural number x is a natural number that is given information, and the sum of that natural number and its square, that is 30. So we can simply write it as, see, the natural number x plus square of it, that is x square, sum of the natural number x and its square is 30. So we write it is equal to 30, and now it is a quadratic equation. We can write it into the standard form also. So here we will get, it says x square plus x, we write the square term first, that is positive x square in the left side only, we didn't transfer that to the right side, it is there in the left side. First we write square term, then we have to write linear term, it is also positive, so we write plus x, and now we have to transfer this constant term to the left side, that will become minus 30 is equal to 0, and this is the required quadratic equation. And now we can simplify this quadratic equation by any method. We have three methods in all. First one is factorization method, second one is completing square method, and the third one is, and last one is, that is formula method. We can use any method here. Now second example, here also we have to form the quadratic equation. The product of two numbers y and y minus 3 is 42. We have given the two numbers y and y minus 3, and it is also given that product of these two numbers is 42, and we have to form the quadratic equation for this condition. So we can write here y multiplied by y minus 3, that is equal to 42, that is given information. So we can take the product y into y is y square minus y multiplied by 3, that is 3y, it is equal to 42. And simply we can transfer this 42 to the left side, and we will write the given equation into the standard form. It is very important to write the quadratic equation which we obtained into the standard form, that is ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Standard form is nothing but that is the arrangement of the terms according to the indices of the terms. We have to write first the first term that is having power 2 or index 2, then we have to write the term having index 1, and then the term having index 0, that is constant term, and here constant term is there in the right side, so we will transfer it to the left side, and we will get y square minus 3y minus 42 is equal to 0, that is the required quadratic equation. And the third situation, third condition which we have given, that is the sum of a natural number x, the sum of natural number x and its reciprocal is 37/6. We have given a natural number, that is x, and we have to add its reciprocal to that natural number, and their sum is 37/6, that is the given information. So simply we can write it as the natural number x plus its reciprocal. Reciprocal means changing the number which we get, changing the numerator and denominator. Here we have x, nothing is there in the denominator, mean denominator means we have 1, So we can write its reciprocal as 1 upon x. Interchanging the numerator and the denominator of the given number, so we will get its reciprocal, and here we get the reciprocal x plus its reciprocal 1 upon x, and their sum is 37 upon 6. Now you can simplify this. Here we have variable into the denominator, that is x, so we can multiply each and every term by x, and then we will get the quadratic equation. So multiply each term by x. X is multiplied by x, that is x square, plus 1 upon x is multiplied by x, so x gets cancelled and we have 1. It is equal to 37 upon 6 multiplied by x, that is 37x upon 6. Now simply you can transfer this 6 to the left side. It is there in the division, so it will went into the multiplication. So 6 multiplied by x square, that is 6x square, plus 6 multiplied by 1 is 6, that is equal to 37x. Now transfer this 37x to the left side and we will get the quadratic equation which is in the standard form. So here you can write, this is 6x square minus 37x plus 6 is equal to 0. This is the required quadratic equation. Here we studied how to form the quadratic equation from the given condition or from the given information in the world problem. We will take example number 4, the digit at 10th place of a 2-digit number is, the digit at 10th place of a 2-digit number is greater than the square of the digit at units place, that is x, by 5, and the number formed is 61. We know the digit at 10th place, it is 5 more than the square of the digit at units place, and it is already given that digit at units place is x, that is the given information. We have a 2-digit number, in that number units place digit is x, and it is given that the 10th place digit is 5 more than the square of the units place digit, and that 2-digit number is 61. And the number which we got, that is 61. So we have to form the quadratic equation only. Just we have to form, we have to get, we have to obtain the quadratic equation for this condition, for this situation. So already we have given that units place digit is x. So you can simply get the tens place digit. Here we have given units place digit. It is x. Now you can easily get the tens place digit. You can easily get the tens place digit according to given information. It is given that the tens place digit, the digit at tens place of a 2-digit number is greater than the square of the digit at units place x by 5. The tens place digit is 5 more than the square of the digit at the units place, so we have x into the units place and square of it, that is x square, and more than 5 by the square of the units place digit, so more than 5 is given there, so we write plus 5. If it is given that less than 5, then we will write minus 5. Either we have given less or more, according to that we have to put sign of addition or subtraction there. So tens place digit is equal to x square plus 5. Tens place digit is 5 more than the square of the digit at the units place. So the tens place digit is x square plus 5. And now it is given that this number is 61. Now here so many students, lot of students making mistakes, because we learn or we studied this concept forming numbers in 3rd or 4th or 5th standard. Now here again we have to take care about that each and every number is nothing but that is the sum of the place values of the digits in that number. For example, we will take same number 61. Now 1 is there in the units place, so place value of 1 is 1, and 6 is there in tens place, so place value of 6 is 60. So we can write this 61 as 60 plus 1. Or suppose you have given 75. 5 is there in the units place, so its place value is 5, and 7 is there in the tens place, so its place value is 70, and now 70 plus 5, that is 75. So here also we have to use same thing. The digit which is in the units place, we have to multiply that digit by 1, plus the digit in which the tens place, the digit which is at the tens place, we have to multiply that digit by 10. And their sum is the given number, that is 61. So units place we have x, so we multiply x by 1. Units place we have x, so x is multiplied by 1, plus now the digit at tens place is x square plus 5, but this digit is at the tens place, so we have to multiply it by 10. So 10 multiplied by the digit at tens place, that is x square plus 5, and now this number is equal to 61. This is very important thing. How we get a two digit number, or how we get the three digit number? Suppose the example is given about the three digits, then how you will get the three digit number? So you have to write the sum of the place value of each and every digit. Here we have two digit number, so we write the sum of the place values of two digits only. The digit in the units place is x, and its place value is x only. The digit in the tens place is x square plus 5, and its place value is 10 into bracket x square plus 5. And now their sum, this units this place value of the digit at units place plus place value of the digit at tens place, that is equal to that two digit number. So simplifying this, we will get the quadratic equation. So here x into 1 is x, plus 10 multiplied by x square is 10x square, plus 10 multiplied by 5 is 50, it is equal to 61. And now we will write the given quadratic equation, or the quadratic equation which we get into the standard form. So first we will write this square term. So here we write 10x square. Then we will write the linear term, that is positive x. And now constant term, 50 is already there in the left side, but 61 is there in the right side. So we will transfer that 61 to the left side. 50 remains as it is, and 61 is transferred to the left side. We will get minus 60. And now the equation is 10x square plus x minus 11, plus 50 minus 61, that is minus 11. It is equal to 0. That is the required quadratic equation. Just we have to form the quadratic equation and we get it. Now last example we have. Here only we have to form the quadratic equations, no need to simplify them. Just we are studying how to make, how to obtain the quadratic equations when we have given some conditions, when we have given some situations, or when you have to use these concept of quadratic equations into the word problems or day-to-day life, how to frame the quadratic equation, that we are studying. Now last example we have, the length of rectangle is x is greater than its breadth by 3 cm. We have given the length of rectangle, it is x, and we have also given the breadth, it is greater than its breadth by 3 cm. This length of rectangle x, it is greater than its breadth by 3 cm. Length is greater than breadth by 3 cm means breadth is less than, breadth is less than 3 cm by the length of the rectangle. That is very important thing. Here it is given that the length of rectangle is greater than its breadth by 3 cm. But we didn't know the breadth. We have given the variable for the length of rectangle, it is x. And the information is given about the length only. This length is 3 more than its breadth, means breadth is 3 less than its length. That we have to think carefully. So here we will form the quadratic equation. It is very easy. We have given the area of rectangle as 70 square centimeters. So first we will get the length and breadth of rectangle. Length of rectangle, it is given x centimeter, and now we have to get the breadth. As we know that the length is more than its breadth by 3 centimeter, length is more than its breadth by 3 centimeter, it means that breadth is 3 less than the length of the rectangle, that is x. So here we have breadth is equal to x minus 3. We have breadth is equal to x minus 3. As we have given that length is greater than the breadth by 3 centimeter, it means that breadth is smaller than the length by 3 centimeter. So we write here x minus 3 centimeter, and now according to given information, the area of that rectangle is 70 square centimeter. The area of that rectangle is 70 square centimeter. So we write here area of rectangle is equal to length into breadth. Length is x multiplied by breadth is x minus 3, and area of rectangle is given 70 square centimeter. So we will form the quadratic equation here. 70 is equal to x into x, x square minus x into 3 is 3x. Now just transfer this 70 to the right side, you will get the quadratic equation, that is x square minus 3x minus 70 is equal to 0, and this is the required quadratic equation. Now you can easily solve the examples from the practice set 2.6, and if you have some queries in some examples, then we will take that example into the next video. Thank you.